we want to factor and solve the given quadratic equations. In this video, we'll be reviewing the factor by grouping technique. Looking at our first example, half of the work has already been done for us. Notice that these two products contain a common factor of x minus 2. So in this case, we're going to factor out the common binomial factor of x minus 2 from these two products. So if we factor out the quantity x minus 2, notice how we'd be left with the quantity x plus 7. And this product is equal to 0, so now we can use the zero product property to solve this equation. If this product is equal to 0, then the first factor of x minus 2 must equal 0, or the second factor of x plus 7 must equal 0. So here if we add 2 to both sides of the equation, we would have x equals positive 2. And for this equation here, if we subtract 7 on both sides of the equation, we would have the solution x equals negative 7. So these would be the two solutions to the original quadratic equation. But normally, factor by grouping is used when we have 4 or 6 terms. So to review the factor by grouping technique, we start by dividing the polynomial in half, and then we factor out the greatest common factor of these two terms on the left, and then factor out the greatest common factor of these two terms on the right. And what we're hoping for is that we'll have a common binomial factor like we were given in the first example. So the greatest common factor of 3x squared plus 6x would be 3x. So we'll factor out 3x from the first two terms, leaving us with x plus 2. And then the greatest common factor of 4x and 8 would be 4. So we'll factor out a positive 4, so we'll put plus 4. And that will leave us with a factor of x plus 2, and this still equals 0. Again, this is good news because notice how these two products do contain a common factor of x plus 2, and now we'll factor out the common binomial factor. So if we factor out x plus 2, notice how we're left with the quantity 3x plus 4. And again, we have a product equal to 0, so the first factor of x plus 2 must equal 0, or the second factor of 3x plus 4 must equal 0. So if we solve this first equation for x, we would subtract 2 on both sides. That would give us x equals negative 2. And then to solve 3x plus 4 equals 0, we'd start by subtracting 4 on both sides. This would give us 3x equals negative 4. Divide both sides by 3. This would be 1x, or just x. So we have x equals negative 4/3. So these are the two solutions to the original quadratic equation. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.